Now, squeezed up on the bench right next to me. And they're also going to be chatting about Lovebox and their upcoming Steel City tour.
So if you really do need a reminder, the Human League made electro-pop cool in the 80s and went on to have hits with Don't You Want Me Baby and Mirror Man. Here's a little taster.
Don't you want me? You know I can't believe it.
Joanne, Susan, Phil, wonderful to see you. Thank you so much for coming in.
It's now, Susan.
I did it in that way round. You're still Phil.
Do you know why you did that?
Why?
Because you were singing along, weren't you? You weren't concentrating.
I was
dancing.
You've been doing it all day.
I mean, it's the soundtrack to my childhood. It's amazing. And I mean, you're still touring. It's nearly 30 years. You're selling records. You've got the two concerts that we will talk about. How on earth do you keep going? And how come you're still friends?
That's a lot of questions rolling on.
I think because we've been together for so long, we sort of, it's a bit like a marriage. You get to know when someone's in a bad mood or whatever, and you keep your distance and things. And you know, we're not together all the time at home, sort of thing. And we really love what we do, more importantly. We're very lucky.
I love the story, though, about how you first recruited these two beautiful women, and you had to go and ask, rather like a Victorian drama, you had to go and ask Dad if that was all right.
Yeah, that was a very, very scary thing to do. But I put all my makeup on thinking that would impress the fathers. It didn't at all.
But you had a lovely long flop of hair in those days, I remember, because I also...
You had a flop of hair.
It was more the sort of childhood to soundtrack to my early 20s, perhaps, or 30s even. But the two dads were happy.
Eventually, I think I convinced them somehow. It was a long time ago and people didn't want to be their kids to be in groups then.
Yeah.
Do you find that you've got sort of a real mainstay of very loyal fans, or are you attracting new people all the time? What do you see when you look out?
There's a very solid core of people that really, really like us and like our kind of music that really help us everywhere. And we try and entice a few more in.
Yeah. I think a lot of people now bring the kids along. There's this sort of that our generation, so they've got like teenagers. So we get quite a lot of teenagers coming along. Yeah. And a lot of people bring toddlers, don't they, strangely enough?
It's very strange sometimes when you're on stage and there's like a 10-year-old in front of you knowing every single word and you think, oh, wow.
Now, Lovebox, Lucy was talking about a moment ago. That's this weekend, you've got that coming out. But then there is, as I said also, the Steel City Tour and the small matter of Heaven 17 on the same bill. Is it all forgiven and forgotten and we all love each other now?
It sort of really is, yeah.
Sort of was the key word in that answer, Phil, wasn't it, really?
Yeah, I think in those days we had Interview Tourette's and we used to say some things we knew we shouldn't say, but we always really liked each other. Even then we were sharing studios and things. We're looking forward to it.
Yeah.
One of the other things, just very briefly, that I love is that you say you always sing live and you never use playback.
No, we don't.
We always sing
live. Brilliant. Yeah. And
well, I think it's not fair to the audience. If an audience have paid to come to see you, I think the least you can do is sing live for them. And you can tell we sing live. We're not that perfect.
But it's very interesting when you know that a review has not been, because they say it was all on recorded.
Yeah. Well, it's a tribute to you. Lovebox this weekend, Steel City tour,
running
right through, back in Hammersmith in December, I think.
December.
Brilliant. Well, it's great to see you again. Thank you for finding time for us. Thank you. Righty-ho, marvellous. So, before the weather, here's what's coming up at 6:30.